Hi, I'm Tara Hitchcock. You are watching Harkins Theaters Behind the Screens, a very special on-location edition of Behind the Screens, because we are in Liverpool, the birthplace of the Fab Four. What would the world be like if there were no Beatles? Well, we had a chance to sit down with the cast and the folks behind a movie called Yesterday, which kind of examines that premise. Take a look.
Oh, I believe in yesterday.
When did you write that?
I didn't write it. Paul McCartney wrote it. The Beatles.
Who?
The Beatles and that collaboration, it is all about joy and the respect they had for each other. So what about this collaboration was most like a John and Paul collaboration?
Ooh, we have to be very careful about people saying that because you kind of like...
What does that mean?
Yeah, it's like... I think...
You know, it's not a bad metaphor that I'm... a bit soggier than you and you've made tougher things and I've done more sentimental things. But then of course the magic of the Beatles was they both tried to please each other, so they wrote songs almost in the other person's style and mode and area, didn't they, to create delight.
And you're right, the collaboration is one of the extraordinary things about them. There's many extraordinary things about them, obviously the quality of the songs and their effect upon society generally and things like that, the variety of their songs. But actually one of the most extraordinary things is their collaborative process through which they worked, which was incredible and was one of the reasons that they produced so much and so much quality really. So you're right, collaboration is a key word with them, I think.
And I used to direct movies, but Danny's better at that than me, and the pleasure of thinking, oh well, here's this scene where he finds out that the Beatles don't exist. It's going to be great when Danny directs it, whereas with me it would have been a bloke switching on a computer and going, oh. Move on.
I've been waiting half my life for you to wake up and love me.
I feel like one of the big morals of this movie is if you have a secret crush on your best friend, don't wait over 10 years to say something.
Yeah, right.
Sure. I wouldn't put the blame at Ellie's door, though, for not saying anything. She's definitely made it quite clear. It's just Jack who's just being, perhaps choosing to be a little blind to it.
Oh, yeah! But what was the most amount of people that you actually had to perform in front of?
5,000 people we performed in front of Goulston on Sea, where Jack's from, top of the Pier Hotel at that moment. It was actually 5,000 people turned up on the day.
On the beach, it was wild.
It was a crazy day, like helicopters, but yeah, all these people screaming, it was so amazing. And it's so amazing that they all showed up.
Do you think you're now a better singer and better performer having, this is basically music, you know, a master's program in music.
Completely, yeah, totally. And I mean, what a privilege to improve my playing and my singing by singing these amazing songs.
The long and winding road.
I know you guys get asked all the time what's your favorite Beatles song, but I'm gonna flip it. What's a Beatles song that you kind of can do without?
Well, there was a song, I can't remember what it's the B-side of, called Rain. Not crazy about rain.
Yeah, I'd go for that one as well.
Please make some noise for Mr. Jack Mallett.
This is just a charming film. I think you're going to really like it. If you want to see more with the cast of Yesterday, including the advice that Ed Sheeran gave to Himesh, because he's in the movie playing himself, basically, just go to the extended version of my cast interviews on Harkins.com.